Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. Two of the best teams in the game square off. It's the Cleveland Guardians and the Boston Red Sox. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. Just about set to go now. Today's starting pitcher, Pablo Lopez. Chris, what should we keep an eye on here with him?
Well, he got into the eighth inning his last time out, really pitching deep in the games as of late. We'll see today how many innings he's got in him.
All right, just about ready to go here at Fenway. Now it's the power speed combo, Jose Ramirez. Here comes a pitch. Good eye right there.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Puts it in the air out towards left center. Badu has this one sized up. Hauls it in for the out. Here's the Guardians lineup now. And this is a dangerous group, Chris. Top to bottom, loaded with guys who can barrel up the baseball. A lot of high exit velocities, and that all results in a club that's leading the league in slugging percentage right now.
And Boog, that means the pitcher's got to be ready from the very first pitch of each and every at bat, because these guys, they're ready to jump all over you, and they've got the swing speed, the velocity through the zone, however you want to measure it, to hit the ball hard and hit it a long way.
There's no question this is a lineup that is built to win in today's modern game of baseball. Kicks and deals. In the air, right field, Verdugo settles under it. Hauls it in, two away.
Batting third, the shortstop, Patrick Conley.
And it's fouled away. No score, just getting started, top of the first. And now it's filled up. That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. Pulls it in on the warning track. Guardians go down 1-2-3. Cleveland nothing. Sox coming to bat. You're dialed in to the show. Back here at Fenway, today's starting pitcher, Tristan McKenzie. And Singy, it's unique these days, but he's more of a pitch-to-contact type of guy.
Yeah, Boogie, he doesn't rely too heavily on the strikeout. He knows he needs to miss barrels, get some soft contact, let the defense do work behind him. And I think a guy like that can keep a good tempo, don't give hitters time to adjust or think. They can move through a ball game, and you look up, they're in line for a quality start. We'll see what he's got in this one.
Next pitch downstairs, ball two. And he deals. Fouls one off, two and two. Left-hand hitter waits. Fly ball down the line, Phillips turns and moving to his left, makes the catch, and there's one down.
Batting second.
Check out the Red Sox lineup. And a big factor for them in recent games, Rafael Devers.
And Boo, he's the table setter for this offense. Team leader and on-base percentage. I mean, that just gives your teammates plenty of chances to cash in and bring them around to score. Man, I used to love when I had a guy out in second base or third base. Easy to get those RBIs. Game after game, you know a guy like this, what he's going to provide and the opportunities that other guys are going to get in the lineup.
And now it's 1-2. That one not close. And it's 2-2. Next pitch is in the dirt. 3-2 now. In the air out to center. And he makes the catch. And there's two away.
Don't be talking reckless. Batting third. Not shortstop. Xander.
And here is Xander Bogaerts. Bogaerts hitting better against right-handers this year, so some reverse splits there. The 1-1. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. He can't get there. It's a base hit.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. Ripped that one down the line and kept it fair. And even when you hit it that far out front, you still have to keep your hands tight to your body so you don't hook around that baseball and put it in foul territory. And that right there was perfect.
And a pitch. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. End of one. And we're still scoreless. Back in Boston, all set for the start of the inning. Now it's Franmil Reyes. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on-base and slugging too. And another ball.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable. And because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
Bounce to the left side. Over to Dalbec. Leadoff man retired here in the second.
Batting fifth, the left fielder, number 9, Eddie Rosario.
Here's Eddie Rosario. Second inning here, no score. Bounce to the right. He handles it himself. Two up, two down in the top of the second.
Batting six, the first baseman, number 23, Josh Bell.
Josh Bell at the plate now.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Bogaerts with the throw to first. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Nothing doing for the Guardians there. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Bottom half of inning number 2. And now here's the veteran DH, Justin Turner. Here's a 1-1. And a swing and a miss there.
One and two.
One, two now. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
You see how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
Got him. Now one away.
Well, classic pitch sequencing there to change eye levels for the punch out. That fastball on the pitch that before was up. It was very competitive. And that gets you thinking that he might try to climb the ladder. But then the curveball out of that same tunnel just falls off the table and you can't make contact.
Bobby Dalbec. Up next for the Red Sox, good power, not great in the OBP department. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. Pulls it down and there's two gone.
Batting 7, the second baseman, number 5.
Here's Kike Hernandez. In the air, right field, Phillips under it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Nothing doing for Boston. We'll move to the third with no score. Back here at Fenway, on to the third inning. And now the right fielder, Brett Phillips. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Draw back to first. Pitcher gets to the bag for the out.
Good fade and sinking action of that changeup. Got that hitter to roll over.
And now it's Ahmed Rosario. Top of the third, no score. Swings through that one.
Well, at that velocity, if that's all you're seeing, 88, you can handle that all day long. That's what you get in batting practice. But off the velocity of the fastball, that is a very tough pitch to adjust to.
Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Two outs, base is empty. And here's the rookie catcher,
Bo Naylor.
So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Righty to the plate. Breaking ball, and that got him. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch.
Well, that one might sting for a bit, but it helps the team, and it boosts the OBP boost. Sometimes that trade-off is worth it, but well, sometimes it's not.
Next pitch is outside. Kicks and fires. Just missed.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
That one ripped. That's back. Turning and looking, and it's gone. Jose Ramirez bops one out. His 23rd of the year, and they throw a pair on the board. It's 2-0.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Jason Dominguez digs in now. Now all even up. Stays alive. The wind and the pitch. This to center field, Duran sizes this one up, makes a nice grab at a full sprint, and that'll do it. Cleveland with a pair on this blast, and it's 2-0. And we're back here at Fenway Park, set for the bottom of the third, and now number three.
And there's one thing on his mind this at bat, get that first hit at the big league level.
1-1 now. Line to second, snagged on the bounce. Rosario tosses to first. Leadoff man retired here in the third. You know, Singy, they talk about Red Sox Nation, but there is something to that because the Boston Red Sox aren't just about Boston or Massachusetts. It's that whole New England area. So you're talking about Maine, New Hampshire, Vermont, Northern Connecticut. There's a whole segment of the country that is locked in on the Boston Red Sox pitch to pitch throughout the summer. Tosses to first, and two straight set down to begin the bottom of the third. And next for the Red Sox, Akil Badu. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. On the ground to third, and that should be extra bases. And that's going to kick into the corner. Around first and hustling for second, and he's in ahead of the throw with a double.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. A well-deserved double on a great swing. Got everything going on time. He stayed balanced and he squared it up about as well as you could possibly ask. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Badu stands at second with two gone. Bounced up the middle. Out with room to spare, and that's the inning. One left for the Red Sox, and they're down 2-0. Start of the fourth. Here's a big power threat. Patrick Conley. And a pitch. Gets under it and pops it up. Hernandez under it. Puts the squeeze on it. One away.
Now batting. Designated hitter.
Now it's the DH. Franmil Reyes.
El Boogie consistently hits the ball hard. His exit velocity and barrel rate. Here the tops in the league.
On the ground. And he punches one right back up the middle. That's what he does. Great contact. And that knock bumps his hitting streak into double digits, Chris. He's hit 10 straight.
Yeah, and on a nice trajectory. Average going up, OBP. Everything he's doing at the plate right now just seems to be working.
Eddie Rosario digs in for the Guardians. Next offering is foul back. Next offering way off the plate. And a pitch. Oh, now this one is blasted to right. Forget it. Way back there and gone. His 21st of the year, and they add to their lead. It's 4-0.
When you're working with this kind of velocity, so critical that you move the ball around, work quickly, and make sure that you keep that hitter off balance. Clearly not fooled by the location or the velocity. He was all over that fastball.
Josh Bell digs in for the Guardians. Grounded out his first time. And now the count, 1-2 after the swing and the miss. Why to kick the pitch. And that's outside.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Lopez gets the swing and the miss. That's the second out.
Well, that at bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there. At least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
Two outs. The bit behind with that swing. It's strike one.
Sometimes a hitter will go up there and guess, and it's not just pulling something out of the sky.
Now that's strike three and the third out. So we take a break. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now a 4-0 ball game. Ready to go, bottom four. It's Xander Bogaerts now. The Red Sox in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at bat out of him right here.
And the 2-2. Out to short. Conley gloves it, gathers, and throws to first. One out in the bottom of the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Here's Rafael Devers. Devers, the baby-faced assassin.
So, Boog, you went to college in this town. What was it like for you being a college student and having the opportunity to bounce over here to Fenway Park and see some games?
Yeah, in fact, 1990, a couple of college classmates and I, we were in college. We bought standing room tickets, and then the next night got a chance to see the Red Sox clinch the East against the White Sox in that sliding catch in the corner by Tom Verdansky. The Red Sox would end up losing to the Oakland A's in the playoffs, but that's one of the things that I'll think about in terms of memories from going to college and going to Fenway. And that one in the air center field brings it in for the third out. Red Sox go down quietly. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. We go to the top of the fifth. Stepping up for the Guardians, Ahmed Rosario. The pitch. Line drive, base hit, right center field.
Up next for Cleveland, the catcher.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Pablo Lopez will depart, and as he heads for the dugout, we'll take a quick break. New arm on the mound when we get back. Nick Pavetta into the game. On for his 20th appearance of the year.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Bo Naylor at the plate now. The pitch. And there's ball four. Now it's Jose Ramirez. Singy, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He is the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
Two, two down. Hit on the ground, might be two. There's Hernandez handling the chance. Off balance feed, there's one.
Tough play right there. Didn't really have enough time to set his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off, and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
And here is Jason Dominguez. And there's a fly ball deep right field, and it slams off the bottom of the wall. Run scores, but a terrific play to get the out.
The base runner did a great job of making that a close play at the plate with an excellent slide. Maybe the catcher worked to get out there and put down the tag. But throw was on the money, and that's what made the difference. Big time play to cut down a run.
So in now for Cleveland, Patrick Conley. The 2-1. Swing and a high fly ball in the air left field. And it's gone! That one felt good, and they boost their lead. It's 7-0. That's their third home run of the game.
They're having a lot of fun at the plate in this one. They've got the long ball working for them on autopilot. There was a fastball down the middle. I don't think the hitter recognized the pitch, but once he did, was quick enough to get it in play with some authority. He got that up and out of here.
So now the DH spot, Franmil Reyes, 1-for-2. Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. In time. So the drop third strike doesn't hurt him, and that's that. But they strike for 3 in the inning. 2 on this 2-run home run. It's now 7-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. So stepping in for Boston, Bobby Dalbec.
clearly down in this ball game, and you can't look at the deficit and try to get it all back in one swing. It's got to come one at bat at a time, and even shrink it down smaller, pitch to pitch. Make that guy on the mound work to get you out.
Righty delivers. Taps softly to the right side. On to first, and that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth.
Now batting, number five.
Enrique Hernandez up next for the Red Sox. Flied to right his first time. The pitch. And that's downstairs and outside. The pitch. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Phillips makes the catch, and there's two down.
Now batter, number three.
Now it's going to be number three.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
Three. Got him looking. Out number three. Down in order go the Red Sox. Not going their way. It's 7-0. So I ain't saving you a cleaning house. Do you think that's just a statement? Then you ludicrous like it's word of mouth. I knew. Back inside Fenway Park, top six. Here's the left fielder, Eddie Rosario. And here's a 3-2. This one popped up. Devers moving under it. And there's one down.
Now batting, the first baseman, Josh Bell.
And now the switch hitting first baseman, Josh Bell. And he walked him.
Well, that's a really good take right there, and that's just mentally prepared, knowing that if it's now not on a tee, you're going to take that pitch because you still have one more strike to work with. Not easy to lay off, but he did an excellent job in that plate appearance.
Here's the 2-2. That one hammered center field. That's back there. Pulls it in on the warning track.
The batter number one, second baseman, Ahmed Rosario.
Ahmed Rosario digs in for the Guardians, and he's already singled in this game. Ball to strike. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Now batting. Catcher.
I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way, and it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
And now the catcher comes up to hit. Bo Naylor. That hits the dirt. And it's 2-1.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
2-1 now. Two aboard. Just off the outside edge.
Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
Two outs. Couple of base runners at first and second. And that one fouled off. Next offering is fouled back. Three and two now. In the air, pretty deep out to center field. Durant giving chase. Nice grab on the run. And that is that. 9-1 and 2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. It's the Guardians 7 and the Red Sox nothing. Back here at Fenway Park, John Schompe with Chris Singleton in the booth, and leading off the bottom of the sixth, Jaren Duran. Three-two. That's towards center. Dominguez drifts towards it, hauls it in, and there's one away.
Now batting, the left fielder, Akil.
And stepping in for Boston, Akil Badu. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports too. Cut on and miss, struck him out. So he's gotten deep into this game, and at least so far, not showing a ton of signs of fatigue.
Allen, Verdugo.
Two outs, bases empty. Alex Verdugo up next for the Red Sox. The pitch. That's inside. Next offering is down low.
A rare three ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
The wind of the pitch. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. And that's the inning. And the Red Sox leave one. They continue to trail 7-0. You know how it goes, 1-1-2-1-2. That was the zip code. December 27 was the birth of Kanata, the Met fan born in the home. Back now at Fenway, top of inning number 7. Now here's the switch hitting power threat, Jose Ramirez.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
Next pitch misses way outside. The Red Sox with some bullpen action. Jake Brents, a lefty, looks to be getting himself ready. Brazier, the right-hander, also getting loose. Next one in the dirt.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
Right-handed reliever. Fouled off. He was late. And a pitch. Ripped on a line. And Ramirez is set down. And there's one away.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it. But sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
Jason Dominguez digs in for the Guardians. One down, base is empty. He dives, but can't hang on. That's a base hit.
The batter, the shortstop, Patrick.
Patrick Conley digs in for the Guardians. Right-hander kicks, deals. And a foul ball, he stays alive. One, two now. In the dirt,
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed. It's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. They tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
Swing and a miss, 3-2 now. Plenty of offense in this one, Singy. I guess you'd say kind of what we expected, though.
Well, this was a game, looking at the pitching matchup, where you expected offense to score, and not as lopsided as this. But, yeah, you definitely expected to see some offense coming up.
Up the middle. And that is that. Midway in inning number 7, and it's time to stretch. It's the Guardians 7 and the Red Sox nothing. Back here in Boston, now it's Devers at the plate. Red Sox fans are frustrated, no question. Manager out of the dugout now, and he will make a move to dip into the Guardians bullpen. So Cleveland brings on a new reliever, Clay Holmes, and a healthy sized lead for him to go to work with.
Hotline blinging, hotline ringing, why they keep calling me? I don't judge, but your fake case closed, and I ain't got.
Yeah, the righty deals. Swings through that.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Here's a 1-2. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at-bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. Smash that one through the infield for the knock. When it's hit that hard, it makes it very tough on the infielders to make any sort of play.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Man at first, here's Bobby Dalbec. On the ground right side, 4-6-3 double play. And the inning is over. This one pretty well decided at this point. We look ahead to inning number 8. It's the Guardians 7 and the Red Sox nothing. And welcome back. Now the left fielder, Eddie Rosario. Two now. And that one wrapped foul. Slow roller to first, and that's just foul. The 2-2. Stays alive. And here it comes. Good eye right there. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Around first, heading for 2. In safely. It's a double and his second hit.
The first
sheesh Singy, that was a laser shot, and a good thing we have StatCast to give us the details.
Yeah, get out of the way on that one. That ball flew out of the box at 112 miles per hour. You talk about generating a ton of power in that swing. He did it with quick hands, good lower half, and just unloaded on that ball.
Here's Josh Bell. And now this one's a rocket to right. Way back there. Gone. That'll fire up the dugout. That's career homer number 149. And they tack on to their lead. It's 9-0.
That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
So the Red Sox bring on a new pitcher, Jake Brents. He's into the game with the bases empty.
Well, I think that what makes him so tough against left-handers is he hides the ball for a long time. And from that same side, harder for you to determine which part of the plate it's going to end up on.
Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Brett Phillips, for the fourth time tonight. Check swing, went around. 1-2. And a 1-2. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Misses, and it's 3-2.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And a swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. Now, Ahmed Rosario.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
Inside, and it hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Well, definitely a breakdown in his mechanics on that one. He just lost the handle and ended up way off target.
Brents picks to first. Rosario back in standing. And a 3-2. Rosario on the move. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Very close off the outside corner. Could have easily been called a strike in that location.
Here's Jose Ramirez. At the belt and fires. Up the middle. And there's a hit. Rosario around third. Well, he thought about two, but he's back to first safely. The run comes in to score from second, and it's a double-digit lead as they're up by 10.
Well done. Drives in the run. Couldn't get any air under it, but he smoked that ball back up the middle. Timing was just perfect. Got great wood on it, and there was just no chance for the infielders with how hard he hit it.
So first and second with one man gone, Jason Dominguez digs in for the Guardians. Kicks and deals. And that one clips the corner.
The count is 1-2.
And now the lefty. Pitch misses there. And that's ball two. Naylor, the lead runner at second. Ramirez over at first with one away. And it's filled up. And a pitch. And that'll load the bases.
Boog, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a full scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. This one's got a chance. And it's off the wall. Pulls into third safely as three runs come in.
Just a beautiful triple from start to finish. Got a pitch he could drive, turned on it, and hammered it out front into the gap. Right out of the box. I love how he was hustling, and I think he knew he was going for three as soon as it touched down.
So the Red Sox go to the bullpen. Ryan Brazier. He's got a runner on third to deal with. And now Franmil Reyes. Here comes a pitch. Swings through that one for strike two. And down on strikes he goes. Now two out.
Well, that slider down and away, it's just kind of a slow death. With two strikes, you're looking to protect. And halfway to the plate, you know you've committed, and you know you're going to have no chance of touching it. Tell you what, sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
And now two balls and a strike. Righty to the plate. Swings and misses. And out two and two.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. The 2-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That'll end the inning after a lot of scoring. So in the end, 10 men come to the plate. Six of them come around to score. Last half of the eighth coming up. The Guardians lead it 13 to nothing. Back here in Boston, now it's the second baseman, Enrique Hernandez. Swing and a miss.
One ball.
As he was out front that time. The wind and the pitch. Hits softly on the ground to third. Sends it to first. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
That's what a good sinker's designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
Number three up next for the Red Sox.
Ball.
Next one misses, and that's ball two.
Two and two.
Lifted in the air, right center field. Phillips on the move, and it's caught for the out.
The batter, the center fielder, Jaren.
Two outs, bases empty. Jaren Duran up next for the Red Sox. And a count one and two. To the right side. Bell takes it to the bag, and that is the third out of the inning. Red Sox go down 1-2-3, still looking up at a 13-0 score. You could encounter the great. Back here at Fenway, new inning getting started. And the batter now, Josh Bell. In the air, out towards right center. Duran on the move to his left. Drops into the glove, and there's one down.
Now batting, right fielder, Brett Phillips.
So up next, Brett Phillips. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. Bounce to the right side, and he handles it himself for the out.
Now batting, the second baseman, Ahmed.
Next to hit, Ahmed Rosario. Here's a 1-1. And there's a ball. And downstairs. And the right-hander deals. And that one is lifted in the air. Makes the grab on the run. And that'll do it. To the bottom of the ninth we go. Top of the order, due up. Guardians on top, 13-0. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth. Brooks Raley. And he's got a nice lead to work with.
Raley.
Bottom of the ninth. Now here's the Red Sox leadoff hitter, Akil Badu. You talk about the power and the speed together.
Oh, we knew he was going to be a stud just coming up, making his way through the minor leagues, and quickly at this level, an impact player.
That's out to center field. Dominguez makes the grab. One down.
The right fielder, number 99, Alex.
Here's Alex Verdugo. He's a guy, Chris's highlights include some of the best throws from the outfield that you will ever see. Definitely one of the best arms of the sport. Kicks and fires. And now just two outs away.
Yeah, the infielders and the catcher can never give up on a play, because if this guy thinks he has a chance, he's going to throw it from the warning track if he has to.
Now the throw to first on the run. They get him, but it was pretty close.
Deceptive slider right there. Stayed in the tunnel a long time. Got that hitter out front, rolled over it, put it on the ground.
And here comes Xander Bogaerts. 1-for-3. This one high in the air to left center. And that'll do it. The Guardians slug their way to a win in this one.
After four wins in a row, you start to think a little bit that you're on a roll, and that's the momentum that just takes on a life of its own. Guys start hitting up and down the lineup. Never know who's going to come up with the big hit, who's going to come out of the bullpen and get the big outs, but it's a good feeling, and you want to extend it.
Final score in this one, 13-0. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shamby. We'll see you soon.